We're back.
Good morning, everybody.
Welcome, Nina Bhasin.
Thank you.
And those of you that don't know Nina, she owns and operates Condo Document Inspection Corporation. And Nina, you've got a long history with CIR. I asked you how long you'd been a partner, and it's a long time.
I've been a partner with CIR for the last 13 years, and it has been a great relationship, and I'm enjoying it as much as everybody else, you know?
Great, great. So some changes over 13 years, obviously.
Definitely, definitely, huh? Yeah. Well, when I first started the business, I was on my own, and then, of course, the business grew with the help of CIR and other realty companies that we work with, and now I have a staff of 5 full-time. And we are busy, but we really appreciate all the business that we get from CIR.
Good.
I always encourage CIR realtors to give me a call if they have any questions or areas of concern that they're experiencing within the condo document relation services,
right,
and everything. So they do call us. So we really appreciate that.
Yeah, and the nice thing, you do so many that you've actually seen documents for almost every condominium in town,
more
if
or
not
less,
everyone.
More or less,
you know.
Yes, yes.
So you may not have up-to-date copies of documents in your files, but you have been or know a lot about the places, especially the ones with problems.
Not only that, I have a history. So when you are doing condo document review for the last 13 years, you develop a history about what type of condominiums, what areas of concern each of the condominiums have, and what are we seeing today?
Right.
You know, so basically we find that, as I pointed out in some of my questions, to say, why are there special assessments? Well, special assessments occur when the condominium corporation does not have enough funds in their reserve fund to do a major project like roofing, windows and doors, or anything that happened that was unplanned.
Right.
Right? Even if the doors and windows were covered in the reserve fund at a future date, and they happen to have to do it now, it's something
the
that
the funds aren't there yet for
the
that.
The funds are not there yet, yes.
Right.
So then the corporation has no choice but to do special assessments.
So, I mean, from a realtor point of view, when we list a property, the best thing that we can do is to get an update, new documents.
Yeah, so the seller's realtor will probably have some sort of documentation. So yes, when they do sign off on the contract, the seller's realtor does provide documents. And when the realtors come to drop off the documents to us, we check them thoroughly. And I would say 95% of the time, we are missing several documents because
right,
the seller probably assumes the fact that they have everything, and we get outdated documents. So we sort of have a checklist that we follow. We make a list of all the documents. We email the realtor and say, we've received the docs, we have checked them. These are the documents that are missing. Get them to us as soon as possible so we can complete the review as quickly as possible.
Yeah, and it's pretty important. I mean, condo rules and regulations don't change very often. Condos financials and reserve fund studies and reserve fund plans do.
Change, yes, all the time. Financials change, budgets change. You know, things like, you know, AGMs that were, you know, impromptu that were held because they're doing a special assessment. It's important to get all the documentation. And sometimes we have a lot of problems getting documents. Like when we're sending emails to realtors and say, we need this. And they said, well, I can't get them. And most of the time, they're available online.
Yes.
We do provide a service that we can order documents for the realtors if they are missing documents. And we do have an admin fee that we charge for that. Because it's faster. We know what we need to get. And it's much, much faster so that we can meet the deadline of the condition date.
Okay. So I know from sitting on REX, now I have the documents. What are one of the problems? And parking is a huge problem.
Parking is a huge problem because people don't realize there are several ways. There's assigned parking. There's parking stalls that are leased. and then there are parking stalls that are titled. Title means that the seller or the owner owns the parking stall. And a lot of times when we see purchase contracts and stuff, they've either put assigned or leased and everything. But when we look at all the documentation, we find out that there's also a title parking, you know. So we put that in our report to make sure that the seller is the buyer is aware of the fact that there is a title parking stall.
So I'm a realtor, and I get this question. We get it 3-4 times a month,
yeah,
through Quick Connect or walking into an office. I'm listing a condo. First of all, how do I tell if it's a conventional, bare land, or other style of condo? Let's just...
Well, I would suggest you pull the plan, and in the plan it would show whether it's a bare land condo, a redivision, or a conventional.
So we're looking on spin?
Yes.
And we're taking the register,
the
legal plan number, which is part of the legal description, and we're going to survey plans and plugging that in.
Yes.
On page one of the survey plan, in the legend on the right-hand
side, it
shows
everything, what type of condominium it is.
It discloses what it is and how the unit is described in the registered size.
Yes.
Right?
Because exactly.
Some include balconies. Some of the
majority
old
of them don't use include
right.
balconies, but some do. Yes.
Some of the older ones, for a while there, for a year
yes.
or two, they were
yes.
they were trying to raise the square footage in the registered size, so they did things like that. So now I know what kind it is, but again I'm back to the titled stalls. How do I know if this has a titled stall? Is there a?
Well, most realtors pull title.
Right.
So on the title, they have on the registration side, on the title number, there is always a plus one or a plus two, which indicates either a title parking, two parking stalls, or a title parking, title storage.
Title storage.
So when they will have a plus one, you automatically pull that number so that it gives you the title number of the parking stall. It gives you the title number of the storage.
There you go. Don't forget that. Also, one of the, I believe, one of the great places to get information is from the tax information.
Exactly, yes.
If they're paying, if they own it, they're going to be paying taxes
absolutely.
On it.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And let's see there. So there's a few condo companies that do inspection of documents. What makes CDIC different, Nina?
Well, first of all, I believe that the level of service that we offer to clients is second to none. We do encourage, we are one of the only companies in Calgary that offer a one-on-one consultation. So when a buyer purchases a condo, we do their document review. We ask the client to come in and sit with us. We go over all the documentation, the report, and they can ask any amount of questions. And I encourage buyers that after they walk away with their binder, to call me if they have any additional questions. I can assure you most of the other document review companies do not even have that. If you are going to call for additional questions, there is a charge, and we don't have that. We have one charge for all the services that we provide, and we believe with, you can go on my website and see all the acknowledgments and recommendations that other realtors have made about our services so that it's important that when you are sitting with a client to provide the kind of service that they want. You know, we just don't want to hand over a report and say, here, look
right.
at it yourself and then call us maybe. You know, so we do encourage them to call us. We answer questions all the time. We have people that I've done reports for the year before have called me for questions. So there's no problem with that. We are always available to answer questions.
Okay, and I have to say I know that's the case because when I have questions, I call Nina.
Yeah. So I encourage everyone. I encourage all the realtors at CIR to use my information, my background in finance and document review services, to ask me questions. If you are worried about a particular condo, if I have the information, I am more than happy to share part of it with you. But because of privacy policy, I cannot tell you everything.
Right.
But I will be able to tell you if there are issues with this complex or not. And I encourage you all to give me a call so that, you know, it helps you make your deal better.
There you go. So to get a hold of Nina, go to the virtual office, click on partners and preferred suppliers, and you'll find her contact information is there. Phone numbers and email and everything is there. How long, if I'm writing an offer today, how long do I want to put in for condo documents, assuming I can get all the documents in 2 or 3 days?
Okay, so once we receive our document review, we require at least 4 to 5 business days to complete the entire transaction. From the date that we receive the documents, and we check them. If we are missing documents,
right,
we call the realtor, about 4 to 5 business days. Sometimes longer, depending on when the documents were ordered and when they're supposed to be provided,
right?
So minimum of 4 to 5 business days. We never, never miss a deadline, never.
There we go. So you don't sleep either.
I do. Our offices are open between 8:30 and 5, Monday through Friday. And I encourage all of you to give us a call and ask us questions. And I always will say, I'm not saying that you have to deal with CDIC, but I encourage you guys to call me and ask questions, because we are available for everybody to ask us questions.
I know historically when you're dealing with partners, there's good relationships and bad. Our longstanding relationship with Nina and her organization, there's been a couple of bumps in the road where realtors don't like the report that comes back, but that's the report.
Yes.
And able to get that through. I know there's a lot of regular customers that are amongst our realtors.
Yes, absolutely. And I thank everybody for the continued support. I really appreciate all the business that we get from CIR. And this is somewhere where you develop relationships. And I feel that I've developed a relationship with CIR and the realtors that work with us. And they always call us and say, hey, tell me about something. Can you tell me about this condo and what? And I'm more than happy to talk to them.
There you go. So pick up the phone, give Nina a call. And thank you for coming today.
Thank you for having me.
Sitting through our half hour of Steve and I chatting back and forth. We get to do it again right away. We're going to talk about the anti-spam legislation. And I have to say, it may be boring stuff, but you need to listen to this. The fines are substantial, and the fines could happen as soon as July 1st. So we'll be right back.
Thank you, everybody.
And thanks, Nina, for being with us today.
Thank you so much.